Just a quick reminder, guys, these narrations are best enjoyed with headphones on.
Happy Halloween, everyone. This year I wish three out of System Shock territory to review a game that has been regarded as a classic of the horror genre. Does this game score Halley this year? Let's find out. Before we get into the review itself, there has been a creepy message encoded in Morse code appearing in random videos in recent months. Here it is again. Here is the actual message encoded in Morse code. Decoded yet, it reads,
in my restless dreams, I see that town.
With that aside, on with this review. Konami's Silent Hill franchise is one of the most recognizable franchises of the survival horror genre. The series' debut was released for the PlayStation in 1999, but the game, along with Resident Evil, normalized the survival horror genre. It has been hailed as a classic title of the genre itself. The original game has a massive impact on a lot of modern-day survival horror games and mods, so therefore, the game's influence on the industry is undeniable. Due to the success of the first game, Team Silent immediately initiated the development of a direct sequel in 2001. This classic game was released for Sony's recently released console, the PlayStation 2. The game itself is set in the town of Silent Hill, Maine. Fun fact for you guys, did you know that the setting of the games is based on an incident that happened in Centralia, Pennsylvania, involving a coal steam fire in a mine located under the town itself. Because of the incident, the town's population dwindled from 1,500 to a mere 5 residents. Nowadays, the town itself is still deserted, and the cause of the fire remains unknown. The story itself is based on the Russian novel Crime and Punishment, written by Fyodor Dostoevsky. You play as James Sunderland. You were drawn to the town of Silent Hill by a letter from your long-deceased wife, Mary Shepherd Sunderland, claiming that she is waiting for you in her special place. It is up to you to explore the town, filled with demonic monsters, and find out what really happened to your wife. The accessibility of a 9. There are no colorblind modes available, but there is very little need for one. There are no color-coded elements that will cause an issue for a player with a visual impairment. On ability, we scored a subpar 6. When you are exploring the various environments of Silent Hill and is close to an enemy, your radio should sound. In the Silent Hill games, you are surrounded by fog, and in some areas, the darkness hides on what's going on around you. Therefore, you are mostly relying on audio cues when an enemy approaches you. This puts a player with a hearing impairment at disadvantage, as you are mostly unaware when an enemy is in close proximity to you. Apart from that, the game is mostly accessible for a player with a hearing impairment. Next on the agenda, mobility, given 11. In terms of button layouts, there are 4 options available. In the first entry of the series, you are forced to use what is called tank controls. You use left and right to, well, turn left or right, up and down, yep, you guessed it, moves you forward and backwards. Critics of the original game said the use of tank controls makes the controls feel a little clunky. However, in this entry of the series, you could turn on an alternate stick layout, in this case, 2D controls, which allows James to move in whichever direction
you move your left stick. This makes the controls feel more simplified, therefore easier to play. On top of that, the HD collection, the button layout can be completely customized. This allows you to customize whichever button layout is suitable for your impairments, so a mobility impaired player will be able to play this game with no issues. Last but certainly not least, gameplay scored on 11. If I were to compile a list of epilepsy-friendly survival horror games, I would definitely put this game in the top 3, if not number 1. I understand that this game is 20 years old, but it's aged like a fine wine. Team Silent has done a phenomenal job creating the sequel to one of the most recognizable, influential titles of the survival horror genre of the 90s. The developers has used the volumetric fog, even darkness in indoor environments, to make full use of the PS2's hardware capabilities as a knock-on effect to create a feeling of isolation and loneliness, and in some cases, helplessness and powerlessness. The story is, for its time, a masterpiece, as James travels through the town, battling his own psychological horrors and unraveling the mystery of his long-deceased wife, with the odd puzzle or two to slow the pace down. The way that the game is presented is somewhat unique. Instead of creating a fast-paced, action-oriented survival horror experience, the game takes a slower pace. Enemy encounters are a lot less frequent. This builds up tension, leading to a climax when you least expect it. In summary, Silent Hill 2 is one of the best horror games I have ever played. Yes, more modern games, for example Outlast, was indeed a lot scarier than Silent Hill 2. The game still holds up, even to this day. This is one of the games I was playing during lockdown. Similar to Final Fantasy VII, playing through this game was somewhat of a rite of passage. This game is backwards compatible on your Xbox One and Xbox Series X consoles thanks to the HD collection. Yes, it still has some setbacks, but it still doesn't track the experience of playing this game. The version of this game included in the HD collection comes with an additional episode, Born from a Wish, which tells the Silent Hill story in a whole new perspective. If you're a fan of the horror genre and you haven't played this game yet, you're doing it wrong. And the overall score is a highly respectable 92.5%. And so, as Tails and Lucky escape the haunted town filled with the undead, necromorphs, and the infamous pyramid head, they breathe a sigh of relief as a ray of sunshine pierces through the fog like a dagger of light. They knew it was over. They're safe. By the way, guys, if you need a joke, we've got you covered. Why are girls such bad liars? Because you could always see right through them.